Hello, I'm Dr. Adam Maulana, an ear, nose, and throat ENT specialist. One habit that many people underestimate is letting soapy water accidentally enter the ear during a shower. Although it seems harmless, this can actually lead to serious ear health problems, especially if it happens repeatedly without proper care. In this article, I'll explain in clear, scientific, yet simple terms how soapy water disrupts the ear's natural balance and how to prevent and treat it safely. The chemical nature of soap and its effect on the ear soap, whether liquid or solid, contains surfactants, active cleaning agents designed to dissolve oil, grease, and dirt. On normal body skin, this works effectively because the skin has natural oils that can regenerate. However, the skin inside the ear canal is very different. The outer ear and ear canal have very thin, sensitive skin with minimal oil production. This is where earwax, cerumen, plays a vital role. Earwax is composed of lipids, fatty acids, and natural antibacterial enzymes that act as a protective barrier. When soapy water enters the ear, surfactants dissolve this protective wax layer, stripping away the ear's natural defense. The skin becomes dry, irritated, and vulnerable to infection. Even mild exposure can cause itchiness, discomfort, or micro-injuries to the canal lining. What happens when soapy water stays inside the ear aside from removing natural protection? Trapped soapy water also causes excess moisture within the ear canal. This combination of moisture and unprotected skin creates the perfect environment for bacteria and fungi to grow. The most common infection resulting from this is otitis externa, also known as swimmer's ear or outer ear infection. Typical symptoms include pain when touching or pulling the ear, a feeling of blockage or fullness inside the ear, persistent itching, clear or yellowish discharge, temporary hearing loss. In severe cases, the infection may spread to nearby tissues, causing swelling, fever, and intense pain. Chronic infections can even damage the skin structure of the ear canal. Chemical reactions and long-term risks. Soap products often contain alkaline ingredients, artificial fragrances, and synthetic preservatives, all of which can cause allergic reactions or irritation. People with sensitive skin, children, and the elderly are particularly vulnerable. Over time, repeated exposure can lead to dry, hardened residues from soap and water that were not properly drained. These residues can adhere to the canal walls, creating a sensation of blockage or muffled hearing. Attempting to clean it with cotton buds or hard objects will only push the residue deeper, risking injury and worsening infection. The ear's natural self-cleaning mechanism. The human ear actually has a built-in self-cleaning system. When we chew or talk, jaw movements help push earwax outward. Once it reaches the outer ear, it dries and falls away naturally. However, soapy water disrupts this process by dissolving the wax and altering the ear's natural pH balance. Normally, the ear canal's pH is slightly acidic, which prevents bacterial growth. When soap makes it more alkaline, microbes can thrive easily, leading to infection. How to prevent soapy water from entering the ear? Here are simple steps to keep your ears safe during bathing. Avoid directing water spray into the ears while showering. Shield the ears with your hands if needed. Never use cotton buds. They only push debris and moisture deeper inside. Tilt your head sideways after showering to let trapped water drain out naturally. Use a soft towel to dry only the outer ear. If you often feel moisture or fullness after bathing, ask your doctor about preventive ear drops that maintain ear health and prevent infection. When to see a doctor, you should visit an ENT specialist if you experience persistent pain or itching in the ear, any fluid discharge, a feeling of hearing loss or muffled sound, dizziness, or ringing in the ears. Your doctor will use an otoscope to inspect the ear canal. If an infection or blockage is found, they may recommend antibiotic or antifungal ear drops or perform professional ear cleaning using a gentle suction or irrigation device. Conclusion: soapy water may seem harmless, but when it enters the ear and remains trapped, it can cause irritation, infection, and temporary hearing problems. The ear is designed to clean itself naturally. There's no need for aggressive cleaning or inserting objects inside, simply preventing soapy water from entering and allowing your body's natural system to function is the best form of ear care. From now on, treat every shower as a chance to clean your body safely, not as a risk to your hearing. Because ear health doesn't just depend on how well we hear, but also on how wisely we care for it every single day.